So yeah, listening and learning from you, it's so very clear that that style is or definitely should be something, you know, an important focus in men's lives. What's your philosophy when it comes to children? You know, for example, do your wife and you decide what gets bought and what they wear, or do the kids choose for themselves? How do you have that set up in your
house? Oh, like the style of our kids? Like, yeah, we don't even have that I've never had that conversation, actually. It's like I let them wear whatever they want as long as there's no dress code. It is something that I'm, you know, like I take my kids, they work for me. Actually, my 14-year-old works for my company and my 10-year-old does some work for my company. So I took them to a conference in Palm Springs, California, and we, all three of us, flew out. Mom stayed home with the younger kids, but I always try to expose my children to business. In this case, it's like, you need to look good. You need to look professional. We're going to it was a YouTube conference, and it's just something that we practice good. I right now I focus in on behavior more than I do style. Because again, style can be an instantaneous, very quick change. I think you could pick up in a very short amount of time. Behaviors though, and mannerisms and mindset, that's something that I think takes years to really learn. And so I focus more on my children, like more of developing their moral character and their, you know, my son spends a lot of time in the gym. He spends a lot of time he plays football now, but I will focus on life habits. So I'm more concerned with him making his bed and keeping his room clean than I am with what he wears. Not that, you know, and we haven't had any extreme issues where he's wearing something that is like bad or anything. But he does wear a lot of athletic clothing. He probably, you know, he does think track suits are, you know, acceptable almost anywhere. So sometimes I need to dress him up a bit more, but he knows, hey, if we're going to a business event, I need to wear a button down shirt. He's not wearing a suit. He doesn't need to, you know, he's 14, but he'll wear a very nice collared shirt. He'll wear nice trousers, and he has, you know, decent shoes, and that's all I expect.
Exactly. Well, I appreciate that. No, what I've noticed here is that, as you know, I live in Spain. And when I drop the kids off to school, there's such a difference in how the kids are dressed. And some kids are dressed, like you can tell, they've definitely been dressed by their parent. They're so dressed up for going to school that it's like,
yeah,
wow. So I was really wondering what your take was on that. So I appreciate
it. Yeah, in some places, I think in an urban city, like we homeschool our children. So for us, we spend a lot of time. And I know in Europe, that's not always nearly as common. I think in some countries, it's even like against the law, unless you've got like certain like permits or something. But for us, it's our children, you know, but we still go to a number of social events. My daughters are ice skaters. My son, you know, plays sports. So every single day they're going in and interacting with people. And that's something, but you know, for them, where they're dressing, there are certain uniforms. My daughters last night had dance, so they're wearing ballerina outfits. They, you know, tutus. They've got other uniforms for the different dances. So they realize that, hey, there are certain uniforms and stuff expected. But yeah, their day-to-day wear, not too crazy or anything.
Exactly. Great. Hey, man, I hope you got all the information out of this that you were looking for. If so, make sure you hit the like button and subscribe if you haven't done so already. And if you hit the bell, then every time we come out with a new video, you will be informed. For now, thanks for listening, and I hope to see you soon.